So we also get a lot of questions from people who are coming from those kind of more traditional Linux environments where you have a configuration file and you're used to just like dropping a file in a directory and having it good. How do I convert? Our argument would be, and correct me if I'm wrong, Nate, you should just use Network Manager and NMCLI, and you should put that in your automation scripting or your post-installation kickstart scripting as a script rather than a yep. configuration file you plop somewhere. You should use bash shell scripting with NMCLI to make the same changes that you were making before, just in a new and more modern way. But some people like files. So Nate, do we have something to tell the people that like files?
Yep. The blog that was written somewhere around the time that RHEL 9 came out, because 9 was when there was kind of the biggest shift in how, I think when RHEL stopped reading the old IFCFG files and translating them to these new key files, right? And the blog tells you basically what the key files look like, where to place them, and how to interact with them. But I'm going to tell you that the interaction is, you might as well switch over to NMCLI scripts instead. Make a bash script that executes NMCLI to do the work. The alternative here is you make the key file, and then you have to tell Network Manager to read the key file into the database anyway. It's not like it's reading the key file on the fly like it did with the old network scripts. Use it at your own risk. If you really need to be able to make files that define your network interfaces, if that just works for your workflow better, the blog helps you understand how to do that.
Yeah. And the big thing is that changes you make to the file are not immediately reflected, right? Even if
right.
you...
Which is similar to how the network scripts worked in the past. You always had to make the change and then down and then up the interface, right? I don't know. I guess it's similar, but there's a better way now. Why don't you use the better way?
So if you use files, it's different, right? You got to make your change in the file, and then upload it to the database, and then down and up the interface, or just up the interface so it rereads.
Yeah, from like a workflow perspective, it's like make the change, execute a command to apply the change, which is what you were doing in the past with the networking restart or interface up and down and up. Anyway, my point is, don't do it that way.
Yeah, don't. So our takeaway for today, you want to try some networking stuff yourself with NMCLI, because it's new to you. We have a lab that is free and interactive. I'll also make sure to put this in the episode guide so that you can try this on your own. I'll put the link to the blog there too. But yeah, you can try it on your own and use NMCLI and follow our self-paced lab for making this happen. I saw a couple of questions. There's one on how to monitor the bonded interface. What is it? IOstat gives you the network in and out. So that'll give you the network.
Does IOstat give you network? I thought that was for disk.
Oh, you're right. Man, see, this is what happens. We go off script and try to answer things off the top of our head.
Yeah.
There is an issue. The blocks being transferred in and out of your machine by networking, and it will also outline what's going in and out through the bonded interface and its components. Oh, and Shantanu says Endtop is a good
tool. That could be true. Yeah. It's been a while since I've had to monitor bonded interfaces. And I think the tools were different when I was doing it. But I think it'll also show you a link status in... Does IP show you link status? I know ETHTool used to. Does ETHTool still exist?
ETHTool exists, but it's one of the deprecated tools.
Yeah, there's a replacement for it that I'm slipping at the moment.